सो लेट्स सी द रिव्यू ऑफ कॉर्वस ओएस वर्जन 12 एंड्रॉइड 11 ऑन माय वन रिव्यू. लेट्स स्किप टू द अबाउट फोन. एज यू कैन सी द एंड्रॉइड वर्जन इज एंड्रॉइड 11. द सिक्योरिटी पैच इज ऑफ डिसम्बर 5 एंड द कर्नल वर्जन इज 4.9 कर्नल इज परफेक्स प्लस कर्नल. नाउ लेट्स सी द कस्टमाइजेशंस. इन सिस्टम यू गेट जेस्चर्स. इन दिस यू गेट स्वाइप फिंगरप्रिंट फॉर नोटिफिकेशन. देन क्विकली ओपन द कैमरा. System navigation. In this you get gesture navigation, 2-button and 3-button navigation, and you can also adjust the sensitivity. But this doesn't work. See, in gesture navigation works fine. See, as you can see, it works fine. But when you click on 2-button, see, there is no navbar. 2-button or 3-button, there is no navbar. And even in gesture navigation, with sensitivity full, there is no back action, as you can see. Then you get prevent drinking. Swipe to screenshot, a 3-finger screenshot. And power menu, you get device control. And sensitive content on lock screen. Then Raven themes. You can choose the accent color. You can choose the font type. There are many fonts available. Then you can choose the icon shape. Then in status bar icons, you can choose it. Then QS header style and switch style. Then you get system theme and you can also schedule it. The main customizations are in the Raven's layer. So in the system, get notification. In this you get battery charging light, notification header and center notification headers. And in miscellaneous, you get double tap to sleep on status bar, screenshot sound, status bar items. In this you can choose the items on status bar. Then setting dashboard icons, full screen apps, then vibrate on connect, vibrate on call waiting and vibrate on disconnect. Then in lock screen, you get lock screen items. In this you get double tap to sleep on lock screen, translucent notification background, then lock screen charging info, fingerprint authentication vibration, fingerprint error vibration, media art filter, and music visualizer, charging animation. You can enable or disable the charging animation. Then in status bar, battery options. You can choose the battery style, battery percentage, and battery percentage while charging. And in clock options, you get show clock and date. Then clock style, AM/PM style, show seconds, date, then date position, date style, date format, clock font style and clock font color. Then icon manager, you get old mobile style, you can enable or disable the 4G icon. Then you can also enable or disable the volt icon. You can also choose the volt icon. See, now it's currently this one. See, as you can see, you can choose the logo, EMA icon or say it changes. And you can also choose the VO Wi-Fi icon. Then you can enable or disable the data disabled icon and roaming indicator, etc. And in quick settings, you get QS tint, brightness slider. In this you get bottom brightness slider, auto brightness icon and above footer. Then media player, then vibrate on touch and data usage in QS header. And in traffic indicator, you can enable or disable it in status bar. And you can also choose the placement. Then you can hide arrows, etc. Then in hardware, you get buttons. In this, you only get the volume button customizations. In this, you don't get any option to control the hardware keys, its backlight, etc. And even the navbar customization doesn't work. And in power menu, you can choose what you want to see on power menu. So these are the customizations of Corvus OS version 12. Say network and internet, mobile network. The volt is working fine, as you can see the logo, and Wi-Fi calling also works fine. Then in hotspot and tethering, you get USB tethering, Bluetooth tethering and Ethernet tethering. Then in apps and notification, you get bubbles. Then here you get app compatibility changes. Then default apps, permission manager and wireless emergency alert. Special app access, and in display, you get dark theme, night light, adaptive brightness, styles and wallpaper, and font style, display size, etc. And in privacy, you get permission manager, where you can choose the permission for certain apps, and show password and etc. In location, you can choose the location for certain apps. In security, so you get pattern, but you can also choose the 6x6 pattern. As you can see, I have set the 6x6 pattern. The fingerprint also works fine, and face unlock also works fine. See, I'll show you. As you can see, fingerprint is very fast. So these are the customizations of CoreOS version 12, Android 11. Now let's see the manual camera works or not. This camera tape is enabled or not. As you can see, it's enabled. In this, you get a stock camera. But of course, you can install Google Camera, which I have installed. Then in launcher, you get notification dots. Add app icon to home screen. So source bar, show Google app, hidden unprotected apps, notification gesture, and double tap gestures, and grid option, and enable grid option. And in recent menu, you get clear all button over here. Normally you get over here at the last, but in this room you get clear all button here down. It's convenient, and you also get the screenshot and share option. The Volt is working fine in this room, as you can see the logo. Now let's see the calls are working or not.
198.
As you can see, the calls works fine. The battery life of the room is average. I got around 5 hours to 5 hours 30 minutes screen on time. Rest the room is pretty smooth. I didn't face any major bug. Thank you so much for watching. I'll meet you in the next one. What just happened?